graduated high school in Albuquerque, New Mexico. I am in my second year of working at French Mortuary. You guys who have heard my storytelling, shut up, Benji. You guys who have heard my storytelling, shut up, Emily. The story of working in French Mortuary, my mom died, right? And I was like, I'm cool, I'm Morticia, I work in the mortuary, I'm doing my mom's hair and makeup, I'm so cool. Okay, so fast forward a year, everybody has a work crush. Please raise your hand if you've had a crush on a work crush that otherwise would make no sense for your life, right? But they're there and you got 8 hours. So I think you're hot. And his name was Brad Brain. Shut up. He was awesome. So, like, before Wes Anderson or Christopher Guest were even a thing, I'm so that girl. And Brad Brain studied world music and anthropology, and he was such a nerd. He wore bow ties, and he had suspenders, and his hair was all combed over. We had really interesting conversations. We worked in a mortuary together. Shut up. So I got accepted to two mortuaries. You especially, shut up. My best friends are over here in the corner laughing and pointing at other people. You're not even paying attention to me. But this is my moment. This is important. It's about a mortuary. Anyway, whatever. It's 1994. Shit is important. So, Brad Brain is the center of my universe. I can't tell anybody about it. I told a couple of my friends at that time, and all they did was mock me as much as my best friends now are doing in the corner, who are for shit. Best friends are for shit. So, my point is, Brad Brain was everything. And we would talk, and I would fawn all over him for nothing that meant anything, and I would stay late after a viewing, because that's what you do in a mortuary. I took really good care of that lady, and I like made sure that her concealer was little one blended in so that nobody would notice that her makeup was shit. So my mom has died. You guys heard that previous story. That was a hell of a thing to go through at the mortuary. Everybody was really supportive, and it's been like 6 months, which in a mortuary is like 5 years, right? So we're sitting in the reception area, beg your pardon, like employee area. I don't even remember what they called that, but it's where you have coffee and you talk about the dead person, yeah? Okay, so there are three locations of French Mortuary in Albuquerque, New Mexico. I worked at one, Brad Brain worked at another. Since I pined whenever I thought he would be at my location because shit was real. He had two kids, it didn't matter. I was 19 years old. We were gonna end up together. We were gonna play world music and talk about anthropology and his amazing tie and suspenders and how we matched every Tuesday, and it was going to be amazing. So it was my first opportunity to have coffee with Brad Brain in the employee area, and he came in, and I was at his location, which is downtown Albuquerque, and I wasn't akin to the area, and I felt very foreign and very out of place, and I was very, very nervous. I poured my coffee. He was talking to me. He was finally talking to me. It didn't even matter what he was talking to me about. I don't even remember. It doesn't matter. Because I have so much cortisol pulsing through my blood that he could be talking about the alphabet. I don't give a fuck. Brad Brain is talking to me. Shut up. People come in. They leave the room. I'm relieved when they do. I'm still pouring this shit cup of coffee. It takes forever, yeah? I sit down demurely. I cross my legs in my 18-year-old pencil skirt. I do that crunching my spine position. Right, you know the one. Don't look at me like you don't know the one. I know you know the one. It's 1994, we're desperate. I pour the creamer in my coffee. I reach for the sugar, and I give that shit all it's worth. I pour that shit, and he's talking, so I fawn lovingly, deprecatingly, at whatever the fuck he's saying. I don't even know. Could I tell you? No, I don't care. Brad Brain is talking to me. I keep pouring the sugar into my cup long after I know that the glucose has done its due. And I stir, and I stir, and I stir, and I stir, and that's so interesting, and I'm so happy that you're talking to me. And I take a sip. And I don't know that at the central downtown location of French Mortuary in Albuquerque, New Mexico, that which looks like the sugar dispenser at my location on North Academy in Albuquerque, New Mexico, is salt. Oh. It's not sugar. Those bastards. Who does these things behind themselves so that some unsuspecting teenager can ruin her business crush in that moment? I poured salt for all it was worth in my shit cup of coffee. That's so wonderful. Whatever it is that you're saying, I don't even care because Brad Brain is talking to me. And I took a sip for all it was worth. I probably ruined my electrolyte levels for a decade. Yeah? So, here's the kicker. We all know that I played it off, right? Would you play it off? I mean, if Brad Brained your work crush of all your lifetime that you haven't even been alive for, you is watching you while you drink a sodium-saturated cup of shit coffee? And I gulped it down like an all the Bugs Bunny that it was worth for my life. You were saying? So I gulped that shit down and I drank water for the rest of the day in the Albuquerque heat, thinking about what a fucking dumbass I was and praying to God that Brad Brain never fucking noticed. And I'm telling my girlfriend, who's a manager at the other cooler Albuquerque French mortuary location, what I had done yesterday, because she's been seeing this saga happen for 3 years, because I'm a teenage desperate girl and I work in the mortuary. Do you know how finite the comedy has to be in a mortuary? You get up early, you work for that shit. She says, oh girl, he knew. He knew. How do you know he knew? And she said, because the central location of French mortuary, everybody knows that what looks like the sugar container is the salt container. So, and it's minutes, right? It's like literally a Christopher Guest quality fucking minute, right? Where I composed myself, 1994. Christopher Guest was still doing horrible things in clubs at this time, yeah? So I say, so he knew? She said, he knew. So he knew the whole time I was pouring the salt in my coffee? Yeah. So then he knew the whole time I continued to pour the salt into my coffee? And she said, uh-huh. And I said, stirring it too? She goes, yeah. And probably the whole time you flipped your hair too. So, mortified, I go home and shake in my boots. And I'm angry at all of masculine humanity for allowing me to participate in a charade of my own undoing. I never trusted Brad Brain again. It doesn't mean that I didn't fawn after him and like fantasize about our Wild West safari anthropological marriage scenarios, but I would never, ever in my life trust him around an unlabeled container of sodium versus sugar again.